What's good, guys? It is Trav here from Neighbourhood. Are you finding that coaching your sales and service teams is requiring too much time and effort? Have you noticed that the notes from their calls and meetings are inconsistent and poor in quality? Well, you might need to master the Playbooks tool inside HubSpot. Today, we will go over how to create interactive content cards for your team members to reference and how to use them to create standardized call notes. If you want to take today's lesson offline though, we'll include a free downloadable PDF in the description below. Okay, so you want to get things set up in Playbooks. Before we get started, there's two options to do. So recently HubSpot has opened up the opportunity for you to use Playbooks inside in the starter and professional level. And then Enterprise gives you obviously the option to answer questions that will update specific records. So whatever the two happens, there will be different functionality. Our test account here is a Enterprise account, so you'll see some extra bells and whistles if you don't have an Enterprise account. But let's dive in and take a bit of a look. For those that don't know, Playbooks is a record on the contact property that basically you can click on, and it will basically give you a list of questions, almost like a script, to help you answer the right questions or make sure you get answers to the right questions, whether that be a support or a salesperson as well. Often, sometimes people will skip through and forget questions, so this gives you a playbook, if you will, to make sure that nothing is skipped and all of the information is captured. So first and foremost, if we click on contacts and then go to a contact, we'll see that, click on Tyra here, and down the right hand side, you'll see playbooks here, and you'll see that the playbooks area will be located here. It'll also be located on the deal workflow, but we've actually got to create them. So to do that, click on sales, and then we'll go down to playbooks here. I will say use naming convention and foldering as well to make sure that you have proper organization of your HubSpot account, and do it from day one. Don't 2-3 years down the line say that I should have done it back then and spend all that time. But we'll go through and we'll create a playbook here as well. So now HubSpot does give you a few examples or templates down the left-hand side to utilize. Now we'll use one of those for an example today, and then I'll show you one from scratch as well. So if we go through and just sort of say that it's a salesperson, so it's a discovery call playbook. We're gonna call this, the HubSpot How To Discovery Playbook. And we're gonna click on create the playbook. So what's gonna happen now, this is where we can go through and start to build the actual playbook itself. As it's done here, it's really good to add some notes. Now, the good thing with this is when you're on a phone call, the prospect or person on the other side of the line won't be able to see what it is. So you can add tips and tricks and things like that as well to help give context and remind the person that's taking the call as well, just to remember to capture that specific information or ask specific questions. You'll see down here that we've got before the call, research, create the agenda and set the time that works best for you. And you'll see here that there are a few questions, 3 to be exact, that are: what are the top initiatives? Tell me about your role and what are the goals for the company here as well. So these are questions you can go through and you can edit these questions as well, like write the question, open list question answers, and then update property or hide the field, save notes. Now in this instance, I'm just gonna leave it as is and then I'll create a one from scratch shortly. We'll go up to settings as well, make sure that it's a call, not a meeting, and then also set rules as well. You can also update specific ones once they're done. We're gonna click on publish on this instance because it is a template. We haven't edited it. It is fully customizable. Again, I've got an enterprise account. You won't be able to update certain properties if you haven't got one, but you'll see that there is one here. Now, if I go back to the contact and I go back to Tyra's profile, you'll see that under the playbooks drop down. So we can just pretend we're having a phone call now. And we can see this one here. It's gonna pop up almost like a note. And then we've got these specific information in front of us now that we had up out of that template that we had. So we can, you know, make sure that we research, we can sit there and go retain existing accounts. Example. people. We'll go through, tell me about your role, owner. Again, you can have them as pre-answered questions if you want as well. What are your goals? And then adding some notes in there as well. Now, this is an example. We want to make sure that we select the outcome that we connected, and we might want to create a follow-up task in 3 days to reach back out to them as well. And when we click on log the call, you'll see that it logs much like a phone call. So we'll see here, we've got activities. We've logged this call here, and we can see that all of the relevant information has been sort of captured there. Obviously, if that needs to be in a specific email, we can go control and send an email out via that. But that's collecting that information, and it's making it really easy so that if anyone is having a look at that contact record in the future, they can basically see the answers. But the question goes that, well, what happens if I want to update specific properties inside the actual account, so pre-existing ones as well? So, for example, what is your phone number? What is the name of your company? Things like that. What you want it to do is you actually want it to update the properties in there, so you're not having to go ahead and, you know, click on this and copy it and bring it across here and paste it sort of there. So it updates and does much of the work for you. A lot of good examples of that is that workflows have been attached to certain properties that get updated as well. For example, if they answer a question and the answer is yes, we could go through inside that playbook to automatically go send that prospect or person on the other end of the line specific information based on what question they're asking. How do we do that? Quickly jump in and I'll show you now. So that's the standard one that we've got there. We go down to sales and playbook. And we're going to go through, we're going to create a playbook here. We're going to create one from scratch, and we're going to call it the HubSpot How To. HubSpot How To test example. And we're going to open up this playbook. It should be nice and clean, which is good. So we're going to go through here, and what we can do is enter any information. Let's just say, for example, it is the discovery. Let's go explore. So we're going to want to know some more extra detail. So what we might do through here, I'll just delete this so you can show you what it looks like. We want to go up to the top and insert, and we can videos, or we can embed specific things, but we want a question. Question is, what is your mobile number? Which makes sense. And what we want to do is we want to update a property. We want to update the contact, and we want to update the mobile phone number, and we want to click on save. It should show up like that. Then we want to do, what is the name of your company? Now these are really standard examples, and I'm sure each business is fairly detailed and complex in nature. You can create your own properties and ask how many company staff are there. There might be a whole range of questions, but this is just used as an example. We want to update a property. What is your company name? And we want to go company. And company name. Hopefully you can kind of see the example of it updating the properties as well. Then again, we can mix it up as well and go through and say, hey, I want to add a list of questions. How much money does the business make per year? And we can start to say zero to a million. We could say a million, probably not exactly a hundred. No, that's 100,000. 100,000 to say a million. And then we could say 1 million to 5 million. And we'll go through there as well. And you can see how the different types of, answers that you can do, where they can pre-select them or update specific properties as well. That being said, it's as you go through, like I mentioned, if you are updating certain properties, you can create workflows that sort of says that once this property has been updated and changed, go through and execute it. And it will actually, whether you want it to send specific information or send certain information internally, you can do that as well. Very, very quick, broad example anyway. This is a phone call as well. So we're going to click on publish. So what we'll do is we're going to go back to Tyra. So at the moment, I don't believe her mobile phone number is present. I think it is, but I'll delete it just to show you an example of it updating. Let's go through here and let's go can update her mobile phone number now. Okay, I'm gonna add to the view, bring it to the top. Bring it to the top. Yep, and then go back. Okay, so we've got the mobile phone number. I'm just gonna delete this. Delete this one here. There we go. Oops. Save that. All right, so got a phone call with Tyra now. We're just gonna quickly open up 1 second, review all these playbooks. We're gonna use the test example that we had. Okay, what's your mobile phone number? So we're just gonna say 0414710253. Yep, no worries, that's done. New mobile number, no problems. Always when you try and work fast. What is the company name? You can select the company. Update it. I'll just delete that part. So you can see here that it goes through and updates the mobile phone number. Now you'll see if we go here, we say we've connected and we log this call, what will happen is it will refresh the page and you'll see that the mobile phone number has now changed and it's updated that record as well. And you can try and have a think about a whole bunch of range of really cool things you can do with the playbook, with the property update feature as well, whether sales teams or service teams internally need to be notified about outcomes or certain answers to certain questions as well. You can do a lot of internal communication, but also a lot of external communication as well. And there you have it. You now know how to create and use playbooks inside HubSpot. If you're after a PDF version of what we've learned today, we'll leave a link in the description below. Now, if you've learned something new from this video and you're keen to learn more about HubSpot, make sure you give us a like, subscribe, and hit that bell so you never miss out on another video. Well, that's it from me. Happy HubSpotting.